We are here at Amazon's new headquarters in Arlington, Virginia for the company's annual Devices and Services event, where we expect to see a ton of big new Amazon products. So let's head in. So we've made it to the showroom floor. All of Amazon's new devices are out and ready for us to play with. The real story this year is around Alexa and how Amazon is using AI to make its virtual assistant even better and make talking to Alexa feel like you're just having a conversation with a person. Soon you'll be able to ask things like, how's my favorite football team doing, instead of having to specify your team. Obviously, AI is a hot topic right now. Some people hate it, some people love it, but Amazon seems to be really focused on using it to make the Alexa experience more natural. This is also extending to Amazon's Fire TV devices in a very cool way. You could pull up your Alexa remote and ask, show me a movie starring the lawyer guy from Breaking Bad, and it will automatically know that, hey, that's Bob Odenkirk, here are his films. So out of the many, many products here today, one of the standouts to me was the new Echo Show 8. This is Amazon's smart display that's been around for a while, but it's getting some really cool upgrades. So we're checking out ambient content on the new Echo Show 8, which allows the Echo Show to react to where you are in your room. So when you're far away, you'll see quick at-a-glance content, the time, pictures, the weather, things you could see from a distance. As I'm getting closer, it's automatically reacting. It's showing me more at once. Right now, there's a recipe up there that I could open up. I could give it a thumbs up, give it a thumbs down. But it's a neat upgrade that goes a step further towards letting you use these devices even more hands-free, more dynamically. The new Echo Show also processes Alexa commands locally, so you'll be getting up to 40% faster response times. Amazon also improved the 13 megapixel webcam, and they're also promising improved speakers with better clarity and bass. And it's worth keeping in mind that adaptive content is coming to the previous gen model, so if you just want that and you have the previous Echo Show 8, you'll be good. Now, whereas the Echo Show 8 is more of a lifestyle device, the all-new Echo Hub is designed specifically to control your smart home devices. This is an 8-inch device, it's very thin, it's meant to be easily mounted onto your wall, and it kind of gives you this at-a-glance view of all your connected cameras, your security systems.
You also have all of the aggregated device status across the bottom, so if you want to see the status of the lights across the entire house.
Now, what's really compelling about the Echo Hub is that it works with all the major smart home standards. And according to Amazon, that means that there are over 140,000 devices that'll work with it. Somewhat compelling that the Echo Hub is going for $180 when it launches later this year. That is pretty competitive for this specific category and something we're definitely looking forward to testing out more in the future. So I'm currently trying on the new third generation Amazon Echo Frames, which promise a number of upgrades, starting with the overall comfort and fit. As you can see over here to my right, there are a lot of new styles. Amazon really wants these to just look like normal glasses you would wear in the real world, as opposed to something super high-techy. I don't have too much experience with the previous Echo Frames. I'm not a glasses wearer. I can say that these do feel very lightweight and comfortable. If you took the Amazon branding off of here, you'd probably think these are just standard glasses, which I think is the goal here. There are a lot of improvements under the hood as well. As always, these feature built-in music playback, so you can just enjoy your favorite playlists without headphones. And now you could quickly double tap to activate your music and pull up a number of custom playlists you have set up. Amazon is also saying that you'll get better bass and longer battery life. Another neat feature is that the third gen Echo Frames can pair to multiple devices, which is great if you want them to easily connect to your phone, your laptop. Just kind of removes a little bit of that friction of having to unpair and repair. So the third gen Echo Frames will be available as glasses as well as shades. And they come in a number of styles, as you can see here, including a few from the very popular brand Carrera. The third gen Echo Frames will go for $270 to $400 and will be available for pre-order soon. Amazon did not forget about its younger users, which is why it took the wraps off of the Fire HD Kids and Kids Pro tablets. The latter is aimed at older children, but either way, these tablets are kind of your standard refresh. They're faster than before, they're gonna support new games, and really designed to just be more intuitive. Now, these kid-friendly drop-proof tablets are available to order now for $190. You could also spring for a $200 Disney bundle if you want that nice Disney-themed case. In addition, Amazon is also launching a $50 Echo Pop Kids. Now, this is simply a children's themed version of the existing Echo Pop, which is one of the most compact Alexa speakers. It's available in Disney and Marvel variants. I'm not gonna lie, I'm an adult and I want the Marvel variant. So AI isn't just making Alexa better, it's also improving the ambient experience on Amazon's Fire TVs. One of the big features arriving later this year is AI art, where you can basically generate your own background just giving a simple voice command. You could say, create a really cool looking blue flower, draw me a mountain, and it will generate those things. It'll give you a few options. Additionally, the ambient experience will be able to use AI to modify actual photos. So AI art, obviously not everyone's thing, but if you like the idea of having more options for wallpapers, that will be available for you starting later this year with the customized photos coming early next year. So there you have it. There are a ton of products here. We will definitely be putting these items through their full paces as soon as we can. For more coverage of all the biggest tech products and much more, keep it locked to CNN_.